Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, we have added a few event handling mechanisms to do the operation of deletion and adding a new item to the list view. Whenever we have done this particular operation, we used the method notifyDataSetChanged on the RecyclerView.Adapter to reload the data. Now the question is, whenever I invoke this particular method, does this mean it invokes the onCreateViewHolder and the onBindViewHolder method of the listAdapter? What do I mean by that is, if you have a look at RecyclerView.Adapter, we have these two methods, onCreateViewHolder, which basically does the layout inflation, and then onBindViewHolder, wherein we are actually binding the data to the view. My concern here is, even if I add one data, is it doing onCreateViewHolder and onBindViewHolder invocation again and again? We have logcat statements which will log if and when these two methods get invoked. So let us have a quick demo and see what actually is happening whenever we do notify data set changed. We are revisiting the same codebase again. We will observe what is happening in the Android monitor when I do the add operation or the delete operation into the list view. So let me run this. As you can see here, onCreateViewHolder and onBindViewHolder, both are getting invoked. And after a particular point, you will observe that onCreateViewHolder will not get invoked. It is only the onBindViewHolder gets invoked. That is the whole point of using a recycler view. Let me do a delete operation on the first element. The delete operation is a long click and see what happens. And you will observe that it invoked onCreateViewHolder and onBindViewHolder for quite a number of views here. And this is what you will observe. Every time I do a delete operation, both onBindViewHolder and onCreateViewHolder are getting invoked, because the method that we are invoking here is notifyDataSetChanged. And even if I add a new element here, say sample name, let's keep it short and let me add. And you will observe that after adding, I am invoking notifyDataSetChanged, and because of that, both onBindViewHolder and onCreateViewHolder are getting invoked. This is fine when the size of the data set changes. But what if the size of the data set is not changing, but only the content of one of the item is changing? What do I mean by that is, on click of this particular item, which is a text view, it toggles between male to female and female to male. That particular part of the code I have written here, if it is male, it becomes female, and if it is female, it becomes male. And after that, I will invoke notify data set change. If we do this, you will observe that even though position of the item doesn't change here, onCreateViewHolder and onBindViewHolder getting invoked again and again. This is not necessary. I don't want to create the view again. I want to only just rebind the data. That is why what we will do here is, instead of invoking notifyDataSetChanged, we will invoke notifyItemChanged. And you can tell the position where the item changed. And when you do this, instead of invoking onCreateViewHolder as well, it will only call onBindViewHolder. So let me run this again. And now if I click on the gender, you will see only onBindViewHolder getting invoked for the position 13. Now you don't see onCreateViewHolder, and this is much more efficient. The same can be applied even when I want to modify the whole data set itself. So let me select any one of the item here, and I will change the sum of the values here. And if I just modify once again, you will observe that only BindViewHolder got invoked. Because if you have a look at, you will observe that once again, I am invoking notify item changed. So as a thumb rule, if the size of the data set changes, you should use notify data set changed. And if you are aware that the size of the data set is not changing, only the content is changing, then it is better to use notify item changed instead of notify data set changed. In this way, you can fine tune the performance of your recycler view. If you think about it, notify data set changed informs the adapter that the data set got changed. What got changed? Adapter has no way of knowing that. That is where notify item changed with the position as the argument is much better option. There are few more things to talk about on RecyclerView. I shall meet you in the next video. Stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.